Nityanandam. Welcome back to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Bidadi. You are watching the evening news on NTV on Saturday, August 28, 2010. This morning, much to the delight of devotees and disciples gathered for Sarvadarshan, Swamiji introduced his autobiography, Autobiography of an Avatar. He said the book will be released simultaneously in 100 languages on 12th December 2012. This book would aptly combine factual information and satya or truth from the master's life so devotees could gain the maximum learning from it. Later, Swamiji introduced his message of the day, conflict-free life. This would be the undercurrent of his autobiography based on the master's own life, he said. Also, it is a rare incident when both the devotees and the master are passionate about the same learning. Today, the master said, was one such situation. He felt strongly about sharing the core of his self, conflict-free living, and the devotees too were passionate about it and ready for his message. Let us watch a small clip from today's discourse.
So I decided this should be the main theme of my whole biography, whole autobiography. The theme is, the subject is... conflict-free life. Just go and sit in Chitsava and come in there. Nothing. Just remember this one truth. Conflict-free life. Life is conflict-free. Life is conflict-free. Conflict-free life. Don't analyze, am I conflict-free? How to live conflict-free life? What is the technique? What is the method? How to go about nothing? Life is conflict-free. If I am living, I am conflict-free. Conflict-free life. That's all. Let us enter into the process. Chitsava. So the devotees who are watching from around the world, I request you all also, just sit wherever you are for next 21 minutes with this one truth, conflict-free life. That's all. I'll be there working with you all, doing the living enlightenment process.
Swamiji followed this strong introduction to the theme of the day, conflict-free living, with an intense meditation conducted for the LE participants and the ashramites. They were asked to meditate on today's Nityananda Sutra. What is conflicting in us has no life. What is life in us has no conflict. What a deeply profound sutra. After meditating on this sutra during the morning session, many LE participants shared their overwhelming experiences during the meditation. Later in the day, Swamiji continued to share his knowledge and experience on this theme during the Yoga Sutras discourse. Taking the example of Zen masters, Swamiji shared how instead of constantly running after goals, even if it is spiritual growth or enlightenment, Zen masters were a classic example of how the path itself is the goal and we should blissfully enjoy the path and hence achieve the goal. During the past few days, LE participants and ashramites alike have been enjoying several wonderful evenings of Upanishad with the master, where he compassionately answered all the questions, spent time clearing all their doubts on the intense process that they were going to undertake during the living enlightenment process. Also joking with them and putting all their fears to rest. Let us watch a small clip of some of the earlier LE sessions.
Mm-hmm. take responsibility, even that is an important way of living enlightened. Whatever you believe, when you stand, work, dedicate for it, that becomes completely you. Cosmos is hypocritical. Just by you blowing your nose little, you'll become enlightened. Nothing doing. All parts of you need to stand for it. For that concept. Add your courage as a strength to that theology. Adding your body as a soldier to that philosophy. They want to reduce the weight easy. Thank you.
Well, that clip showed the master in all his myriad forms, wise and guiding, compassionate like a mother, as jovial as a friend, the all-encompassing guru. You saw him there wearing a Mexican poncho, rolling a Mexican japamala gifted by the Spanish devotees. The Spanish devotees later shared that the robe worn by Swami had sacred significance, denoted by the Mayan religious symbol hand-woven on the rope.
My blessings to all of you. I am with you all. So I have few words to share with you all. Please understand, even if you are physically with me without having feeling connection, Kalpataru may not work. But if you are feeling, having feeling connection, wherever you are, Kalpataru will work. All of you have come assembled knowing that physically I am not there. This shows your feeling connection with me. Whatever you receive in this Kalpataru will stay with you and will work for your life. My blessings. Blessings. Want to tell me anything?
Yes. Yes.
Yes, my blessings to the child also.
Thank you. My wife is here.
Yes, tell her my blessings. I'll see that it gets settled. I'll see that job and green card both get settled. Blessings. Tell me anything. Want to tell me? Blessings. You will experience enlightenment. Want to tell me anything?
Just happy to be here.
Oh, I am with you. My blessings. Love.
Thank you.
Yes. Anything to ask me?
How do I stay aware?
Constantly try to unclutch from the heart center. Have your remembrance in the heart center. and try to unclench from all thoughts. I'll see that you stay aware continuously. Blessings. Yes. My blessings. You have peace. That's it. You will have good results. The efforts you take, you will see now. Blessings. Want to tell me anything? Tell me. Yes. It'll happen. My blessings. You will be able to be here by December. I'll take care. Just send email of your mother's photo. I'll take care. She becomes independent. I'm with you.
As reported yesterday, the participants did indeed make a flying start in the ELE process during the Samana meditation, levitating in the presence of the master. To watch the full clip, you can log on to the Life Bliss Foundation channel on YouTube. In other news, devotees today approached the magistrate court in Ramnagaram to follow up on their complaints lodged earlier. This time though, they were successful. The magistrate accepted their case and promised to review it and deliver the decision on 4th September. Finally, it looks like there is indeed hope for the devotees and the disciples in their long, arduous journey for justice. Well, that's all for today. We will be back with more news at the same time tomorrow on NTV. Thank you, Anandam.